What is up, guys? Welcome to another video. Are we doing some musky fishing today, guys?
Doing a little bit of musky fishing.
Yep, with the spinning rod, some bobbers. No, obviously we are going after some big king salmon. Got Andrew Logan in the boat today with his buddy Ryan. We're ready to catch some fish, hopefully. Yesterday was pretty unreal, huh?
Fashionably late as usual,
Robbie. Yeah, yesterday was awesome for them. I got here late this morning. We're all set up though. Bobbers are in the water. This is gonna be nice. Not chucking baits all day. Just gonna watch a bobber and hopefully set the hook and fight some aggressive king salmon. So that's the program for today.
Oh, okay, what do I do?
Are you going down?
This thing just got dunked.
It just like halfway.
Not enough to set the hook, but it got dunked.
Okay, that's some fresh cane out there. It was just think. Like, what do you give a little twitch? I just don't understand. And this whole king deal is like, how do you guys actually land these fish? There's a lot of docks.
So many docks.
Well, they're all floating docks besides the poles.
Okay.
Like, but, if they run under the dock, you just hold your rod under.
Yeah. This is interesting. This is not like, this is extreme bluegill fishing, right? I'm going to stay as optimistic as I can because remember our last time out here? Andrew, we really were on them. We got some cool jumps.
That's what we're here for. Oh my god.
Film. Are you kidding me?
That's a fish.
That's a fish.
Oh, it's on the one top of the water.
Woo,
that was it out there?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, this is not good.
Oh.
Off.
Broke you off?
I'm so done.
Again?
Oh my god.
Oh.
Yeah, Carly hooked them all.
Hey, you want a panini?
Yeah, that easily. Oh wow. Oh my gosh. I hate life.
Didn't you have a bite there?
Yeah, I definitely had a bite there. I'm blaming this on Andrew. I literally just cast it. Dang it. Okay, one just jumped. Yeah. Okay, I had a bite. It actually went down, guys. That was great.
That was.
I hate that. This is harder than muskies.
Watching him like, is he gonna set the hook?
We put a hook in one.
Yeah, we did.
Colin, thanks for coming along. We've been here forever. Last time we talked to anybody, it was what, 9 o'clock?
Hours ago, my friend.
It's now 2 o'clock,
hours
and
staring at a float.
So you know what? Things are looking up. Hopefully, it's a good afternoon bite. So Ryan, this is how you catch hook. I should say hook.
We're trying to catch it.
Not yet, anyways. I've never seen one caught like this in person. It looks really fun.
Yeah, it looks like a Trojan roll.
Yeah. I'm not liking this.
You don't like the...
Not liking this.
You got it.
At least we're in the middle, you know?
Yeah.
You hooked it in a good spot, but I suppose like it's still... You're really holding that, aren't you?
I kind of got to there.
Give him some tuna pumps.
Yeah, he's right out there. He's out there, that's for sure.
Will they jump this time of year still?
They sometimes. Yeah. They kind of like these docks and these poles. It's kind of what he's trying to do
really
right
focused
now.
Focused on trying to get into that.
Look
pole.
At that rod bend.
Oh my god. Oh, that sounded like my rod was about to break. I heard some crack.
You're
that was not good.
Yeah, wow. Come on, coming at us. Colin, what are you doing with the net?
I'm waiting.
Oh, ready. I thought those are your hands. No tail grabbing?
No tail grabbing salmon, they're a little wild.
Come on, let me see this thing.
Were you trying to double up back there, Andrew?
I want to double up.
I know I didn't want to reel my bobber up, but it was too close to his.
Going for the dubs. Mama.
Wow. This is real, isn't it?
They fight real hard.
It's right by the shoulder.
Really?
No.
Oh my gosh.
Beans!
My man.
Wow. I don't know if I'm ready for this when it happens. Heck yeah, come on.
How do you like those cat shits?
Dude, that rocks.
Yeah, awesome. Collin knows. Collin knows.
Come on.
Watch that.
Oh yeah. Come on. Come on.
Watch the trolling motor.
Yeah. Oh shoot. Okay, you're good. You're good. You're good. Oh. Ow, yeah. Awesome. Dude, nice. Heck yeah.
What was he so mad about? Why?
Just a buck? So that's like an average or just above average? Or
yeah.
Little skipper. Wow.
So that's what a salmon looks like. Thank you, Ryan.
No problem. That was a grind.
Yeah, right. All right. Wow, look at those spots. That's crazy.
Mud shark.
Yeah, right. Dirty water.
Come on, buddy. Oh, God. You ready?
All right.
Collin's got them Indian tricks.
Give him a little breath of air.
Oh my
God. Well, Robbie, your spot.
Oh, wow.
I don't know what happened to it, but it changed a bit.
Changed a lot. Why is there a bunch of crap moving in?
Hello, current picking up, bringing the fish in.
Way to go, man. Right? We got a salmon in the boat. It only took whatever. I don't care, actually.
You know, it's 2:00. We still got some time left.
Maybe the window's open.
Yeah, that was cool. I kind of want to see this happen on myself, but never caught one on a bobber, so we'll see. Good things though, good things. Well, folks, this day is a lot like musky fishing. How many bites have we had? Like one or two.
And then
we're getting these weird little, like the bobber would go down halfway. So I don't know, maybe we'll catch one at sunset or whatever at the end of the day here. But we just want to go through what we're using right now and a little different rig that these guys use down here to keep the skein on. So Andrew's gonna run through this real quick.
We got some eggs.
Okay.
We're just gonna cut a nice respect.
So you get these from the female.
Caught a few females. Take a nice respectable chunk. And right here is the deal. So it starts real tight like that. You push your line through it. It's gonna open her up. You take your eggs and you put it on like that.
Through the hook, yeah, through the kind of it.
And wrap it around and it cinches your eggs up on the hook like that. Now look at, those aren't going anywhere.
Wow, bang, bang.
Very good on windy days and you gotta cast far if you're shore fishing.
That's actually my rod and I didn't have to touch the skein, so thank you, Andrew. That is it's a messy part of salmon fishing.
A very messy
stinky
part.
Yeah. I mean, there is powder all over the boat.
We destroyed Robbie's boat.
That's okay. Hopefully we can get one more fish. But just want to show you that little, I don't know, if you're not using it in the harbors, then maybe you should start doing it. Because it is really nice. It holds on the eggs very good. One more fish? Maybe? We'll see.
Maybe one more.
Well, folks, that is all she wrote. These salmon acted like muskies, which sucks. Just dropped the boys off. Guys, don't forget about this winter. Even into the fall, there's some opportunities to get on some big fish. Still, it's kind of getting late. It's October. These fish are scattering, is what they said. They're still in the tributaries and stuff, but yeah, unfortunately could not get another at the end of the day, but did see one, did get one in the boat, so that's cool. I'm gonna leave all the guys' links in the description below. Make sure to check out Andrew Logan's channel for more of Great Lakes action. But yeah, don't forget about Colin and Andrew for this winter. They run a bunch of ice fishing guide trips for big giant brown trout. So get in early with them, book early, get some prime dates, and get out fishing with them. Guys, thank you so much for watching this. You know, it seemed like musky fishing for salmon, but what can you do? It's fishing. Even though these things are jumping everywhere, it doesn't mean you're gonna catch them. So that is all I got for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you on the next video.